That is all marlin, bro. Holy shit, look at them feeding. That is all marlin. Holy shit, look at them, Dan. Holy shit, that is all marlin feeding, hard out. Look at them, that's all marlin. Oh shit, see that bite. Look at them feed, look at them feed. Right there, Dan, quite close. There must be 20 or 30 marlin or more. Holy shit, look at them feed. Oh, his head come out of the water to eat. They're feeding right in our spread. They're feeding right in our spread, but in front of the lures, they're not following it. Feeding all around us and they're not interested. Look, here's the bait ball right here. Right here, look. Oh, and marlin all over it. Holy shit, look at this. Watch this, watch this. Roll, roll, roll. Look at them, look at them. Oh, there is a shit load of marlin there. And when they're like this, I've had it before, they're just so focused on that bait ball, they just will not eat these lures. And I haven't got any baits to throw at them. Oh, but look at that. Unbelievable, come on, where are yous? Here he comes, on this lure. What you've seen just there is a sneak preview of what we've been witnessing for the last 3 hours, just 8 miles off the coast here. We have not even used half of a tote tank, about 10 litres of fuel in the little boat. And what we've witnessed, I have honestly only ever seen it equaled at the Wanganallas. Now, you're going to be catching that as it's fully produced and comes through. But right now, I'm going to take you through what is new to ultimatefishing.tv this month. And ironically, while we're out here showing people how you can go and catch marlin on a budget, trending now at ultimatefishing.tv is my step-by-step guide on how to make your own marlin lure, the $4 Slayer. With inflation, marlin skirts might cost a little bit more than $4 these days, but I think you'll find if you can make one up for just a few bucks, if it's anything like mine, it has honestly been one of my most productive ever marlin lures, and I'll take you through it step by step, as well as a bunch of other intricate little things that you can do just to help your hookup rate and some basic lure rigging skills.
Here we're back.
And trouble.
Oh no, what lure did we get it on?
$4 Slayer.
Yeah.
And something to look out for, which we're getting content for as we speak, is a full review of this boat, the 1450 Stabycraft. My one, Te Honki, has been set up specifically for game fishing, but also saltwater fly fishing. And I've done a whole bunch of modifications that I've actually done at home myself that you could transfer onto just about any boat. If you like my big boat review, but can't quite afford the price tag that comes with it, you're gonna love some of the detail that's gone into this boat, which I think makes it the ultimate pocket-sized game fishing boat.